All right, so this is how I became TikTok famous. Let's get it.
Elevate, elevate. Only obligation is to tell it straight. So much on my plate, I got it.
It was my senior year of college. I was out in Iowa playing my last year of collegiate basketball. You know what I'm saying? And I came across this little TikTok app. I forgot how I came across it, but I came across it. And at the time, I was on there just scrolling around. And the shit was weird. It's like 2018. You know what I'm saying? So the shit was weird. It was like a bunch of kids on there doing these weird little fake dances to like popular songs. You know what I'm saying? And I was just like, this is weird. I'm cool. This ain't for adults. This ain't for me, especially. You know what I'm saying? But I seen a couple grown folks on there and they was doing like little skits and stuff like that. So I was like, okay, well, it's some grown folks over here, but mainly this app is for kids, so there's no way that I should be up on this app. You know what I'm saying? So that's when I first discovered TikTok. Let's fast forward to like 2020 to when I actually started to get into it. You know what I'm saying? Because before I even started TikTok, I was in a down bad situation. I ain't finna hold y'all. Shout out to my brother and my sister-in-law. You know what I'm saying? Because I had my own crib. I was subleasing a crib from my parents. You know what I'm saying? Because they got a new house. So I kind of like took over the bills at this house until the lease was up. So my parents could, you know what I'm saying? They ain't got to worry about paying bills at both houses. You know what I'm saying? So I did that. But once the lease was up, I ain't had nowhere to stay at. You know what I'm saying? Like I didn't want to take over the lease for myself because it was a 3-bedroom house and I ain't want to do all that. So moving forward, once I moved out of that crib, I ended up moving in with my brother and my sister-in-law. And I was, keep in mind, it was a little apartment. It was already 3 people living in this 2-bedroom apartment. So where I sleep at, I was in the living room with it. I was big living room living, you know what I'm saying? I was sleeping on the floor, had all my clothes and stuff. Everything that I own was in a little corner of the apartment. And then everything else that could have been in the apartment was in my car. You know what I'm saying? So I was living like that, sleeping on the floor. You know what I'm saying? My alarm clock was, you know what I'm saying, somebody walking next to my face every morning. You know what I'm saying? That's how I wake up. Like, oh, shit, what the fuck? And that's just my sister-in-law getting ready to go to work. You know what I'm saying? So that's how I was living at the time. And I was still working at Walmart. You feel me? So then the pandemic hit. Coronavirus, it hit. It hit us all, and you know what I'm saying? It started going crazy. You know what I'm saying? To the point to where folks was getting off of work. Folks was getting sent home. If you was coughing and some old stuff, then yeah, you can't be here. You can't work. You know what I'm saying? So keep in mind, the first half of the pandemic, I was working. You know what I'm saying? It was folks out here getting unemployment. They was doing their thing. Big balling out on the unemployment. I'm at work. And you know what I'm saying? Like, usually, at first, we was told that if the corona hit the building, we supposed to work less. Nah, nigga, we started working more. I was working 12 hours a day for anywhere from 3 to 5 days a week. You know what I'm saying? A straight manual labor. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't gonna lie, I wasn't liking it. I wasn't feeling it. I wasn't liking my living situation. I wasn't liking my work situation. I didn't know what to do. You know what I'm saying? Depression started to kick in. I'm just like, what the fuck has my life become? Because keep in mind, I'm a former athlete, you know what I'm saying? I'm out here trying to live a hoop dream, but that obviously didn't happen, you know what I'm saying? So now I'm coping with this regular lifestyle. It was not the best situation at all, but I thank God and I thank my brother and my sister-in-law for even allowing me a place to rest my head, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to them for that, for real, you know what I'm saying? But it made me realize, like, this ain't it. And at the time, this is when I first started really streaming on Twitch. You know what I'm saying? I was a Twitch streamer before anything. That was like my first social media that I actually put forth effort into trying to expand. So it got to a point at work to where we had to do like this protocol. They would check your temperature. They would ask you all these questions. Have you been coughing? Have you left the country? Things like that. You know what I'm saying? And it got to the point where I was just, I don't know. I seen people was getting sent home if they felt some type of way, if they had any symptoms, anything like that. And supposedly, they was getting sent home with bare minimum 2 weeks pay. You know what I'm saying? So it was one day in particular, I went into work, they doing the protocol, they doing the whole thing. And I'm just sitting there thinking like, I do not want to be here. I don't want to be here. I don't want to work. They are here. They making a slave away. I'm really not feeling it this way. The general manager was there. The person who run the whole warehouse, he was there. And I was in his line about to get checked to go into work. So I'm walking up. As I'm walking up, what I do? Oh, shit. Was a real cough? No, it wasn't a real cough. I ain't want to be at work no more. No, it wasn't a real cough. So if you telling me if I come to work and I cough a couple times, y'all finna send me home with 2 weeks pay? Bet. Oh, shit. So off rip, he was like, come on, let me holler at you. Took me to the office, asked me what was going on. I was like, I got a little cough, man. I don't know. My chest a little backed up, you know what I'm saying? Off rip, he was like, say less. Had me sign some little paperwork. He was like, hit these people up. You gonna get your 2 weeks pay. And then come back whenever you're ready. This is where they fucked up. I didn't have no time span on when to come back to work. They said come back when I'm ready. Knowing me, in this place, motherfucker, I ain't never gonna be ready. I went straight home, sped home. You know what I'm saying? And now the Twitch journey begins. I don't gotta be at work. Let me hop on this Apex and, you know what I'm saying, see what this Twitch talking about. I soon very quickly realized Twitch is a very hard platform to grow. You know what I'm saying? Any platform is hard to grow. But Twitch in particular, you really got to outsource. And picking up his knowledge as fast as I did, I said, you know what? I got to find a way to get people up in here. You know what I'm saying? So what I do? I started a YouTube channel. The channel that you're on right now that you should be subbed to. I started this channel right here. I was like, you know what? Let me try to just make some YouTube videos, gain a little bit of traction, so I could tell them, hey, y'all know I'll be streaming on Twitch, right? That was the goal. That's what my brain was on. You know what I'm saying? It was a plan. It was a master plan behind the craziness. It was a plan, believe it or not. Again, got humbled again very fast. Like, damn, this damn near harder to grow, if not harder, than my goddamn Twitch page. So now I got Twitch and I got YouTube that I'm trying to blow up, and it's just like, this shit hard. You know what I'm saying? It gotta be some other way. It gotta be something else out there that could just let people know, that could gain traction. Now, this is where TikTok comes into play. You know what I'm saying? So now, it's like, it's 2020, pandemic. Y'all know the timeline. And so I revisit this TikTok app. I ain't opened this app up in 2 years. So I revisit TikTok and I'm just scrolling through it. And I'm just looking like, huh. I see adults on here now. I see full-fledged grown folks on TikTok. I see them dancing. I see them doing skits. I see them doing all type of stuff on here. So I'm just like, and not only that, I'm seeing people blow up and go crazy on TikTok. People have overnight success from TikTok. So I'm like, I need that. I could put this app to very good use. I got a couple of homies who was, you know what I'm saying, they was also interested in the social media, and we had some stuff planned to do, you know what I'm saying, YouTube content and podcast content and stuff like that. So I hit my homies up. I'm like, hey, we need to hop on this TikTok. So it was one day, we all met up at my nigga Bully house. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my nigga Bully, man. We all met up at Bully house. It was me, Adonis, and Bully. You know what I'm saying? I was like, we need to find a way to get this TikTok popping. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it could be a great fueler for everything else that we're trying to do. The crazy part was, we had made a TikTok for Adonis's page, and that TikTok blew up, went crazy. It had like 200,000 views within the week. And you know what I'm saying? This is his first TikTok ever. Within a week, that video had 200,000 views, something like that. And he had gained like 5,000 followers off one video that we was all in within a week span. Now me, I'm just naturally, I'm not a hater, I'm not none of that. I see things around me and I let that motivate me. I'm naturally just very competitive. So I seen Adonis' page blow up, and I was like, I want that for me. Like, that's what's up. So seeing that my homie blow up in a video that I was in, it motivated me. Now this time in my brain, it became real. So this shit is really possible. This is really possible, and you could really blow up on this app for real. Just me being a competitive man than I am, I was like, I want more followers than Adonis. Off rip, it motivated me like that. I wanna see if I could pass up Adonis. I went home and I started TikToking. At the time, I didn't know how to do this shit. And I didn't know how to do duets. I didn't know how to do the sounds, the timers. I didn't know how to do anything. But I said, you know what? I could figure it out. I started doing dances. I started trying to be funny. I started telling little stories. I was just, you know what I'm saying? My whole thing was I just want to be funny. I just want to see if I could make somebody laugh. You know what I'm saying? That was my whole thing. That was it. That was the whole get down. A lot of folks think TikTok is just this overnight blow up sensation, which it can be. It was not that for me at all. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy because my mama got 3,000-4,000 followers right now. She posted 2 videos. It probably took me 30-40 videos to get to 1,000 followers. But I was cool with that because for me, it was just about growth. If we growing, that's it. At this time, I didn't have 1,000 followers on anything. My biggest platform was Instagram. I think I had like 500-600 followers. You know what I'm saying? And them was legit damn near all people that I knew in real life. That's legit me over the years, word of mouth. Hey, follow me on Instagram. I didn't care about Instagram. I didn't care about social media at all. I didn't care about nothing. You know what I'm saying? I was a flat out straight hooper. If you see me on Instagram, shit, like the pic. And if you don't like the pic, I don't care. Like, I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was that type of mentality. So the fact that I had 1,000 followers on TikTok, oh shit, we lit. Oh, it's lit. I ain't got 1,000 followers on nothing. You know what I'm saying? So now I'm motivated more than ever. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm trying all type of new content. I'm doing anything and everything because I don't care. I don't care if I make a fool of myself. I don't care if I embarrass myself. If you get some enjoyment from it, I did my job. You know what I'm saying? That's how I approached it. I'm going to figure it out. I ain't asked nobody for no shout out. I ain't asked nobody how to do this, how to do that. I was just on there trying to figure that thing out. That's it. Started to realize, you know what I'm saying? I had one video in particular go crazy. At least for me at that time, the video went crazy. You know what I'm saying? And the crazy part was, it was a video of me talking about my height. I wasn't even talking about it. You know what I'm saying? It was just a sound that was going viral at the time. You know what I'm saying? And somebody had seen one of my videos and they had asked me how tall I was. You know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying? You know, on TikTok, you can reply to comments and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? So I had replied to the comment and I forgot exactly how the video went, but it was like, oh, are you 6'1? No. Are you 6'2? No. Are you 6'3? No. Are you 6'4? All the way up to 6'8. And I was like, yup, that's the one. But keep in mind, you can't tell I'm 6'8 sitting down. You couldn't see nothing. I was literally sitting down like this, like, nope, nope, 6'2, nope, 6'4, nope, 6'5, nope, 6'8, nope, 6'8, yep, that's the one. Literally. It's on my page right now. Literally. That video went crazy. So in my head, I'm thinking, hold on. Y'all like tall people like that? To where all I gotta do is tell you that I'm tall. I don't even gotta prove it. I just gotta tell you that I'm tall. And that's it? Bet, I got you. So one day I was just brainstorming some stuff. I was like, what's the best way to like show people and not tell them? You know what I'm saying? So this one, I was just like, I'm gonna just walk through the door. I'm gonna show my whole body and I'm gonna just walk through the door. And at the time I was doing these little dances. So it was one video, I literally just walked through the door. And I did whatever it was like. It was one dance. I was going crazy. I walked through the door and did the little dance. And guess what happened? That video went nuts. That video went absolutely stupid. You know what I'm saying? So now I'm just like, ain't no way y'all going crazy. Because I walked through a door every single day of my life. It's no way hundreds of thousands, millions of people find this entertaining and I'm walking through a door. They did. They did. You know what I'm saying? So what I do? Kept walking through doors. The door became damn near the foundation of my page. You know what I'm saying? You still see me walking through a door to this day. That door right there. You still see me walk through that door to this day. You know what I'm saying? The content switched up a little bit, but you'll still see that to this day. To this day. So I got the whole walking through the door, doing the dance, you know what I'm saying, thing. And at the time, I would take, it would be, the women had a lot of trends going on. I would try to infiltrate the ladies' trends. Whatever trend that the ladies was doing, I would try to find a way to make it into a trend that men could do too. So that was my thing too. I was trying to find things that were going viral to make it my own. You feel me? But I seen something. It was like a thread that I seen, like a duet thread. And I think the hashtag was like big boys of TikTok. And I was like, damn, I should hop on this. But then I thought again. I was like, oh, I ain't really trying to ride y'all wave like that. You know what I'm saying? I respect what y'all got going, but I ain't really trying to ride y'all wave like that. So I was like, you know what? Let me just do my own thing. Y'all the big boys of TikTok? That's cool, but it's long. It's not really catchy like that. You know what I'm saying? So I said, you know what? Let me just cut that in half. Let me just make it big talk. That's it. Straight big talk. That's it. Because we big over here. We can't help it. We was born big. We going to die big. We going to live big. We just big. You know what I'm saying? My whole family big. You feel me? So I made a video. Legit. This video had no dancing in it. It didn't have nothing in it. Again, somebody asked me. The thing about TikTok is, once you find something that works, you keep doing it. You keep doing it. You keep milking it until it don't work no more. So once I learned this information, I took that and ran. I ran with it. I straight ran with that. So it was one video I made in particular. Somebody asked me how tall I was. I was like, again, I'm about to do something else. You know what I'm saying? Almost doing the same thing in a different way. I was at my mama house. And I made this video. It's crazy because this day I had made like 9 videos. I posted like 9 videos within like 3 hours. Like 5 of them videos went viral. But this one in particular went crazy. It was, somebody asked me how tall I was. I literally just walked through the door on beat. And I was just like, hey, welcome to Big Talk. That thing spread like wildflower. What'd I say? That thing spread like wildfire. It went crazy. It took maybe like 6 months to get to 50,000 followers. So at this time I had like 50K followers. You know what I'm saying? I dropped that Big Talk video. I kid you not. Within like 2 weeks, not even 2 weeks, maybe like a week, I went from 50,000 followers to like over 200,000 followers. And I was just like, y'all know how long I've been TikToking? Y'all know how many videos I done made? This is the one? Me walking through a bathroom door is the one that gives me hundreds of thousands of followers? So what I do? Kept walking through the door. Kept walking through the door, hitting with different dances, kept infiltrating the ladies' trends. I just kept doing what I was doing. I just tried to get better at it. You know what I'm saying? The thing about TikTok is, find different ways to do the same thing. And that's what I did. Got to the point to where, I don't know, people came in because they maybe thought I was attractive, they liked my height, maybe they liked my dancing, whatever reason people came in, they came in. You know what I'm saying? But then I started to go live on TikTok. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't going live like that. I started to go live on TikTok, and then people started to see my personality. You know what I'm saying? I'm realizing when you come across these pages that got a lot of numbers and you see hundreds of thousands and all these likes and all these views, people think of you, they think that you're not a real person, a regular person. You know what I'm saying? Even though I was getting all these crazy views, nothing about me has changed. I'm still sleeping on the floor. Nothing has changed at all. I still go home. I sleep on the floor. I get woke up because somebody's walking next to my face. Nothing changed in my everyday life. Now I just got a couple numbers on TikTok now. So I started to go live, and the lives would be busting. Anywhere from like 100, 200, 300, 400, sometimes 500 people. I'm talking to 500 people, you know what I'm saying? Just being me, being funny, being goofy, telling stories, just being me. And people loved it, man. People loved it. And I started to just tell people about my situation and what I'm going through, because people ask me questions. I would tell them. I was very transparent, still am to this day. Literally nothing has changed about me at all. So I would talk to people, I would answer their questions, I would let them know what's going on with me. And that's it. I would do it in my way, trying to be funny, trying to be some type of entertaining. And people loved it, man. They loved it to the point to where they wanted to support me. They wanted to help me. They wanted to, you know what I'm saying? They just wanted to be a part of the process and help your boy get out of the situation that I was in. And it was overwhelming. I'll put it like this. I had one live where I was sitting in the car. I used to get the car lives to go crazy. I had one live where I was sitting in the car and I was just telling, like, dang, so I guess I'm really all in with this TikTok stuff now. I'm really all in with this TikTok stuff. So, and if I'm gonna be going live, I need to get another phone so I could go live but still engage and interact on my other phone. You know what I'm saying? I told them that. They started flooding my Cash App. They was like, man, get this man a new phone. Like, we rock with you so heavy. We just want to help you get to whatever your goals is. The next day, I bought a new phone because of my TikTok supporters. The next day, I bought a new phone. I was going live every single day. I was just, you know what I'm saying? I was all in the process. It got to the point, I got so much support, man. I was able to legit move out of my brothers and my sisters in law crib. I was able to move out, get my own crib, the crib that I'm in right now. I was able to, you know what I'm saying, save up enough bread to put a down payment on an apartment, get a little bit of furniture. You see, all I got is like a couch and stuff like that. I was able to get a little bit of furniture and just be able to bet on myself. I was, you know what I'm saying, at the time, I didn't know how long this was gonna last. I didn't know how long people was gonna show me love. You know what I'm saying? I didn't take it for granted. I just, every time somebody send me some love, I would just save it. I didn't go out and blow it. I didn't go out. I got necessities that I needed. I got like a phone. I got like a camera. I got like clippers and stuff, cause I still be cutting hair. You know what I'm saying? I got things that would help me make more money in the future. But you know what I'm saying? I just kept saving it and kept saving it to the point that I had enough of a down payment to get my own spot, man. I was like, you know what? If I want to take my content, my Twitch stream, and my YouTube to the next level, I can't be sleeping on the floor, and I can't be, you know what I'm saying? I'm at the mercy of the people around me because they're doing me a favor here by letting me stay here rent free and sleep on the floor. They're doing me a favor. So I can't be up all hours of the night making content. I can't really operate how I want to operate. So I was like, it would be best for me in the content and what I'm trying to do now to get my own spot. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I did. And yeah, man, we've been rocking ever since. You know what I'm saying? The numbers just kept going up and kept going up. So now currently we at over 900K. We pushing up on that million on TikTok. We're pushing up on a million followers on TikTok. What? That don't even, like, still, that don't make sense to me. You know what I'm saying? Because it all started literally by me walking through a door. You know what I'm saying? And I just took it and ran with it and bet on myself, man. I was like, you know what? I have more to offer than just walking through a door. So let me stop being scary. Let me bet on myself and really try to make something of this. And we've been rocking ever since, man. So that's the story on how I became TikTok famous. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to say, for real, anybody who's following me, supporting me, ever dropped a comment, ever liked the video, ever anything, share the video, anything, follow me on whatever, I just want to say, man, I appreciate y'all. Because this is not possible without y'all, man. I swear to God, y'all didn't change my life. For real. I don't know if a lot of people know what my prior situation was before TikTok, but I was down bad. So I done dedicated my life to this content creation, man, because y'all done did so much for me. The least I could do is provide y'all with the best content that I can. You know what I'm saying? So now we moving on to YouTube. So, and we're just trying to keep expanding and keep growing. And the Twitch has been going crazy lately. You know what I'm saying? We be having goddamn 50 people in the chat. We used to have like 3 people. And one of them was me watching on my phone. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, man, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. I'm going to keep doing the best that I can to push out the most quality content that I can. And I just appreciate y'all, man. I'm still low key at a loss of words, cause I don't know. I can't help but to think I'm not nobody. I'm not nobody special. I just happen to be a big kid in a big body. I like to smile, I like to dance, I like to have fun. You know what I'm saying? And y'all rocking me for that, man. So I love y'all, and I appreciate y'all from the bottom of my heart, man. For real, I could never repay y'all, man. I could never repay y'all. So thank y'all for real. Like, thank y'all. I don't know what to say, man. I don't want to get all weird, but thank y'all, man. For real. Y'all legit changed my life, man. And I do not take this for granted at all. You feel me? Like, I appreciate y'all and I love y'all. And we pushing up on 2K subs, man. So sub to the channel. Sub up. Drop a comment. Drop y'all TikToks, man. I'm going to follow some of y'all back, man. Drop y'all TikToks. And, man, we finna keep rocking, yo. You feel me? We finna keep rocking. And shit, smile and shit, dance. You never know what the fuck gonna happen, man. I love y'all, man. I'm out this thing, man. Y'all be easy, man.
Elevate, elevate. Only obligation is to tell it straight. So much on my plate, I gotta.